So on the screen that I opened the slide here, Bhavatah Nama Kim. So these are three separate words. So there has to be a break in between. There has to be a pause in between.
There has to be a pause. That is what I want to ask you.
Yes, yes. It is not one single word. So these three words are there. Between the words, there should be a small gap.
Yeah. Okay. There's no problem with that pause.
Yeah. And also, one more thing I noticed, and it is important, and that it is not Namaha. It is just Nama. There is no Visarga.
Oh, I see. Okay.
This is just Nama. There is no Visarga after Nama. Bhavatah Nama Kim. Bhavatyah Nama Kim. So, there is just Nama. Not Nama. So while telling your name also, same thing. Mama Nama. Not Ramaha. Mama Nama Malati. Mama Nama Krishnaha. So anything will go there. Mama Nama Abhimanyuhu. So that's it. So this is the basic thing.
Can we ask small children Tava Nama Kim?
That is also correct.
Thank you.
So here, Bhavatah, since you have asked, let me tell about a couple things about that. Bhavatah Nama Kim, you use while asking this question to a male person. And Bhavatyah Nama Kim, you ask the female person, Mahila. But Tava Nama Kim, you can ask anybody. Tava means you, like a pronoun, Sarvanama. Yeah. But Bhavatah is Pullinga. So when you're asking a Purusha, you're going to ask Bhavatah Nama Kim. When you're asking a Stri, you're going to ask Bhavatyah Nama Kim. But alternatively, Tava can also be used to ask anybody, whether it is Purusha, Stri, doesn't matter. Tava Nama Kim. Correct. So I'm still keeping this open for any questions.
Is there a difference between the two? Yeah. I mean, what would be the major difference between saying Tava Nama Kim versus Bhavatah Nama Kim?
There is no difference. Both are same.
Bhavatah and Bhavatyah. It becomes as tum or aap.
No, tatha nasti. I mean, Sanskrit, in Sanskrit it is not like that. There is, everything is same. Bhavatah, bhavatyah, and tava, all are equal. Samanapada.
If we give respectably, if you ask, we can use bhavatah, bhavatyah. Is it too? For elder ones?
Tatha. Eka kalpana asti, but I mean, that is one understanding, but it is not true in Sanskrit. Sanskritam, whether it we use tava, doesn't mean there is a less respect.
Okay.
Sir, what I now understood is, instead of using Bhavatah or Bhavatyah, we can always use Bhavanam Kim, isn't it?
Tavanam. Tava.
Okay. Tavanam.
I'm writing on my screen. Tava.
Oh, Tavanam. Not
Tava means you are. Yeah?
Oh, Tava, yes. That can be used for everybody.
Yes, everybody. Male, female, anybody.
Okay.
Even it literally means you are.
Okay, sir.
And just like, and that is a common like misconception, that just that Bhavatah means respect, Tava means not respect, which is not true. This is just like you think that you are using English language. There is no, you are means whether it is a big person, small person, you know, elder, older, same, you are, same thing. Okay, so
sorry, is there any context? Is there any context where we should compulsorily use bhavatya or bhavarya? Is there any context?
There is no context. Bhavatah is for male, female, male, bhavatya female, tava is over anybody. And in Sanskrit, they are interchangeably used everywhere. Yeah. Everywhere, anywhere, if you read Bhagavad Gita, if you read anything, bhavatah, tava, they come in the same sentence. There is no difference.
Okay, sir.
So any other questions? So we moving forward here, we also looked at, I mean, we talked about Pullingam, Strilingam and Napunsakalingam, Linga Vishaye. We talked about the subject of Lingam. So there was a little bit question. I just want to clarify a little bit more about this. Now, first of all, Lingam is attached to a word in Sanskritam, not to the object itself. So a word, for example, suppose we are looking at a we looked at some of the words here. Darpana, for example, darpana. Darpana is a vastu. I mean, I'm going to try to use more and more Sanskrit words in between the sentences. If you do not understand any sentence, please, or any word, please ask. Feel free to ask. Okay? So we talked about this vastu. There is a vastu called darpana, which is looks like this, and what we are going to call it, what we are going to that it is going to be represented by a word called darpana. So there is a physical object. It may be physical. In this case, it is physical. It may be non-physical. So there is an object and there is a word which we are going to use to refer to the object. So there is a separation we have to understand. So there is a separation. The object stands on its own, and there is a, we are going to use a word to refer to the object. So the lingam in this case is for the word which we are going to use, that word to refer to that object, to call that object. So the lingam is for a word. For the word, and the word will refer to that certain object. In this case, it was darpana, and since and darpana is a pullinga shabda. So generally, so what happens is the animals and the birds, animals and the birds, all of them, like they either they are actually the objects themselves, they are of, they have a gender, right? So whether it is a human, animal, including humans, animals means including humans, they, it could be a, it could be an elephant, it could be a tiger, any or it could be any bird also. So all of them, they themselves have a gender, like they could be either a pullinga, a male gender, masculine gender, or a stri gender, or a feminine gender. So accordingly, the word which is used to refer to those animals, of animal group, you can say animal gana or group, which fall into this category, including humans or and the birds. When I say animals, all the birds also. So the words which are used to refer to these animals and birds, they usually, most of the times, 99% of the times, they have the same, words also have the same gender as the object's gender itself. For example, if tiger is a male tiger, then we call it vyagraha. So it is a vyagra shabda is also pullinga. Okay. And similarly, simha, same thing. we call it Simhaha, because if to a male lion. If it is a female lion, it will become Simhi. So because the gender of the object is different, the word, we are changing the word also, which refer to that stri object, because it is either an animal or a bird. So depending on that, the words also change their lingam. So in this case it is clear, because we know that the object is either a animal or a bird. So according to the object's linga, whether what is the gender of that object, the word referring to that object also changes the lingam. So Simha, Simhi, Ajaha means what is Ajaha? So in English, goat. Ajaha, goat, that is he goat. So she goat, we say Aja, like that it goes on. So most of the times, there are some exceptions, but they are very rare in these cases where the object is falls into this animal category. But other than that, any other object, any other vastu which is not animal or bird, then the word can take any lingam. It could be pullinga, strilinga, napunsakalingam in Sanskritam. Yeah. It could be like, for example, tree. Suppose there is a tree. Now, what is the word for the tree in Sanskritam? Vrukshaha. The common word is vrukshaha. The vruksha has pullinga. But there could be same object can have multiple synonyms, multiple words. Not only vruksha is just one word. There are like many words which can be used for to refer to this object which is a tree. Vruksha is a pullinga. Then there is a sasyam, napunsakalingam. Then the taruhu, pullingam. So like that, the words which refer to one single object can have a different lingam. The object is the same, but it can be called by multiple words in Sanskritam. Yeah. So the lingam for non-animals is attached to the words. Lingam is actually attached to the words for whether it is animal or non-animal. But in case of animal, it is very easy to understand, because the word which is referring to that male animal or female animal also takes the same lingam, same form. But if it is a non-animal, then the word which is referring to that object can take any lingam, depending on the word. So the word referring to in this case, for example, we saw tree is vriksha, taruhu, sasyam, so many words are there. So how do we know this? How do we know what is the linga of the word? There are some general rules. Sometimes it is easy to identify or know the lingam by looking at the word. Sometimes it is not, but just by looking at the word, it may not be possible. In that case, we'll have to refer to the dictionary. Okay. So this is an important concept.
Do you have any dictionary to suggest?
Yes. I will send the link in the email after the class. But generally, you can go to spokensanskrit.org. If you can see it on my screen. This is an online dictionary, which is generally it is good to understand word-to-word meaning. It may not be very suitable for to understand the usage itself, but for example, if you can just type here tree. If I can, this is like a Sanskrit, English to Sanskrit. You can see this. So that I'm, it doesn't exactly give, but you can see Druma. Druma is masculine. M means masculine. Drumaha. Shakabhrat, masculine. So many words are there. And on the other hand, you can also search the reverse way also. If you know the Sanskrit word, then either you can, I think you can type it in the, like Vriksha here, probably I will try it. Usually I type directly in Devanagari, so yeah, it will work. You can type this in English also, transliteration, or so it will give you Vriksha, M means masculine. You can see that, and also you can type it in Devanagari, which is easy. So this also will give the meaning as well as the lingam. So this is the beginner's dictionary. It is very handy online. You can just go to the site and type it, look up the word. If you want offline, you can go for Apte. Apte is one of the good dictionaries, Sanskrit English dictionary, which is available for purchase, I think. Okay. Now, about the lingam, do you anybody has any question?
Yeah, I have a question. Ramprasad here. Typically, what used to happen in other languages, when we say normally, non-living things were always considered as napumsakalingam. Like a male is pullingam, female is strilingam.
Yes.
So that means it is not the same concept in Sanskrit. Am I right?
No, it is not. No.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
So the in Sanskritam, it is not the lingam is attached to a word, not to the object. So it is not the same. And also, the it is purely based on the usage, how it has been used in the language for a long time now. For example, kartari we saw the other day, that is a strilingam. Then we have kandukaha, pullingam, and so on. Like, it all depends on the word itself. In some languages, as you said, it is true, but in some other Indian languages also, I think in Hindi, Marathi, and those languages, they are similar to Sanskrit in terms of lingam. All non-living objects are not napumsakalingam in those languages also.
What you will attach? I mean, you attach something to the word, no? No. For to understand?
No. Okay. I'll come to that in a little bit. So first we have to understand the words lingam could be pullingam, strilingam or napumsakalingam. To understand whether it is a, how to know whether a word is pullingam, strilingam or napumsakalingam by usage. Okay? That is the thumb rule. Usage. In some cases, it may be possible to easily identify the linga of a word, but in some cases it may not be possible. So possible to by directly looking at the word if it is a new word. So that is just we'll have to look up the dictionary or talk to someone and find out what is the lingam of the word. Okay. Now the next thing is that somebody asked like whether we can attach something to a word. So there is a general rule we can follow or a general understanding that first thing is that we have to understand in Sanskritam the ending of the word is important. How it ends means the ending swara or the ending shabda, ending sound is important. Like whether a word is ending in A sound, A sound, E sound, Raswa E sound, Virgha E sound, O, like this. And it may not be always the swara or the vowel, it could be a vyanjanam also. Okay? Like like this one, Sharira Bhrut, Vishwa Bhuk, Huta Bhuk, in Vishnu Sahasra Nama Stotram also, there are many words which end in Vyanjanam. So this ending letter or ending sound is also important in Sanskritam, because the words are classified based on the word, based on the sound in which they end. That is the main, the very important classification in Sanskritam. Now, when we say a word, there is something called base word. Base word or the root word, which is also base word or a root word. This is called Prakriti. Prakriti means base word. So, in which word or which sound this Prakriti or the base word ends, that is important. So you may not understand this right now much, but just keep this in mind for now, which will be helpful as we start studying, getting into the actual words. So, by looking at these words, how do they end? Darpanaha, manchaha, vidyuddeepaha, karadeepaha, mandapaha. So, all these are padattanam. These are the actual words. These are not the base words. Remember, there is a base word, a little bit different. But this is the word for the actual object. Darpanaha, manchaha. And similarly, these are also all the words. They are not the base words, but they are the words to refer to those objects. Now let's go further a little bit and study some more slides here. So last time we started studying about saha, eshaha, kaha. So to refer to a masculine object, pullinga shabda, pullinga shabda, we use saha, eshaha and kaha. Saha means something which is masculine, which is far. Saha word is used to refer to some pullinga word which is far. And eshaha is used to refer to something which is near, and the word should be in the pullinga. And kaha is a question mark. Kaha means who. So we saw some of the examples here. Udaharanam kim? Udaharanam eshaha balakaha. Because this is assuming that this is you, the person who is talking, and the balaka is close by. So we balakaha shabda is in pullinga. So forget about the linga of the object. Look at the word. The linga of the word is pullinga here. So we use eshaha because it is near. To say eshaha balakaha means this is balaka. This is boy who is close by. Similarly, if the person or the object is far away and the word for that object is in pullinga, then to say, how do you form the sentence here? Saha vruddhaha, because this person or this object is represented by the word vruddha, and the vruddha is in pullinga, it's a pullinga word. So to say that is the old person. So to say that, we say saha vruddhaha. So eshaha balakaha, because the balaka is close by. Saha vruddhaha, because vruddha is far away. And similarly, eshaha ganeshaha, saha govindaha. Eshaha arakshakaha, saha sainikaha. And so on. So, we went through many of the pullinga words here, and hopefully you have done your homework. Saha Ramaha, Eshaha, Kaha. So, let me move this. So, here Eshaha Kaha. Here is the question. Eshaha Kaha. First, we are going to ask the question. Eshaha Kaha means who is this person? And that object is, the word for that object is in pullinga. So we use this eshaha kaha, because this kaha we use because we know that the object, the word for that object is pullinga. Then only we will use kaha. So we use eshaha kaha, means who is this person? Who is he? Eshaha kaha. Then the answer would be Eshaha Suryaha. The full sentence would be Eshaha Suryaha. Now, Eshaha Ramaha. What would be the question here? Eshaha Kaha, Eshaha Ramaha. And in this example, the question would be Eshaha Kaha, because we are looking at the Deepa, we are looking at the lamp, and we know that the word for the lamp is Deepaha or Vidyut Deepaha, because electric bulb, electric lamp. You can say, you can also say Deepa, it doesn't need to be Vidyut Deepaha. Deepaha. So we know that Deepaha is a pullinga word. That is why we are saying
Saha Kaha, whether it is Saha Kaha or Esha Kaha.
I think it is Saha Kaha.
In this case Saha, yes. Far away. Saha Kaha. Because we know Deepa is a pullinga word, we are going to ask Saha Kaha. Now there was a question that if we do not know the lingam of this word, how are we going to ask? We don't know. We don't either know the lingam, or we don't know the object, or we don't see the object. So generally in the talk we say, we will be talking about so many things. So generally, in the general sense. So what are we going to do there? What lingam has to be used? By default, we are going to use Napunsaka lingam. If you do not know the lingam of the object, and we don't see the object, we don't know the object, so then by default we are going to use Napunsaka lingam. So we'll look at the Napunsaka lingam in a little bit. So atra eshaha deepaha, eshaha kaha, eshaha deepaha. Saha kaha, saha syutaha. Saha, eshaha karadipaha. Eshaha balakaha. Eshaha vaidyaha. Eshaha shikshakaha. Eshaha arakshakaha. Eshaha sainikaha. Saha marjaraha. Eshaha vanaraha. Eshaha gajaha. Eshaha shunakaha kukkuraha. So there are both the words are okay, both are can be used. There are few more words also for same dog, but these are commonly used words. Makaraha. Again, remember that if they are animals, they are all male animals. That's why we are referring to Makaraha. So generally we think that they are male animals. they have male gender, masculine. So makaraha, yeshaha makaraha. Sahakaha, Lakshmikant Mahodaya, vadat sahakaha.
Yeshaha matsyaha.
Kurmaha. Kurmaha. Uttama prayatna hai. So I have some exercise here. Let me start this.
Yeshaha samudraha. Saha kurmaha.
Yeshaha kaha.
Saha vyakraha.
एषः व्याघ्रः
एषः व्याघ्रः
एषः कः
एषः सिंहः
सिंहः सः सः रथः
सः रथः सः हस्तः
हस्तः
सः
एषः तर्पणः
चमसः
So chamasa is a common word, so because we most of the like we use like Hindi also chamacha and all that. So chamasaha. But this may be like a chashakaha. Remember this chashakaha in glass.
Chashakaha.
Chashakaha. So again, I muted everybody because there was some noise. So I'm going to ask one by one. So what you can do is, I'm going to unmute one of you one by one. I mean, then you can go. You can answer like maybe four slides each. Okay, four slides. Let's start with Gauri Bhagini. Gauri Bhagini, so you have to say both the sides, okay? First you have to ask the question, then you answer. Depending on this hand here, if it is small, you ask Eshaha Kaha. Then you answer Eshaha Rukshaha.
Eshaha Kaha. Eshaha Rukshaha. Saha Parvataha. एषः कः एषः समुद्रः सः कः सः मण्डपः सः कः सः देवालयः सः कः सः विद्यालयः एषः कः एषः प्रकोष्ठः सह कह सह शौचालय
अस्तु धन्यवाद भगिनी बहु उत्तमम् सो बाय दिस टाइम आई एम अज्यूमिंग दैट you are all familiar with the Devanagari script. If you are not familiar, please practice it. You know, go home and you can find a lot of books online, offline, and also in this, in my slides itself. In the beginning, there are a few slides which will explain about the Devanagari script. If anybody is not familiar, please practice. Go home and practice reading at least. You know, you should write also. Writing is also important, but at least reading, because as we move forward, we are going to just drop off this transliteration and stick to Devanagari only. So transliteration we are using only just like a training wheels. You know. So we are not going to use it always. So we saw this starting from Suryaha, Ramaha. So what Rama to the last one was Shauchalayaha. So until this, all the words we have seen so far, they are all in Pullinga. The words are Pullinga. See the Shauchalayaha. So this is a Pullingam. Vidyalayaha, Pullinga, so all the words so far, we saw all the words, Pullinga words. And also, you notice that, if you have noticed, all these words end in a similar sound. For example, Suryaha, Ramaha, Vidyuddeepaha. So if you notice that, there is a Visarga at the end, but before Visarga, there is a sound. A. Surya plus Visarga. How is the Surya plus Visarga? What are the sounds in Suryaha? What are the sounds? There is a Surya. Okay. Plus there is A. Plus there is Visarga. This is how the sounds are combined in that Surya. Suryaha. Su, then of course in the Su also there are different sounds, but I'm just writing it. Then Su plus there is a Refa or this Ra Vyanjanam, and then there is a Ya Vyanjanam, that is called Yakara, Vyanjanam Ya sound, and after that there is a is added, then only it becomes Surya. In this Surya, there is a at the end, this A. It is just not Ya, because we are not stopping at Ya Vyanjanam here, we are adding a A sound at the end, A. And after that, there is a Visarga. So all the words we have seen so far, they end similarly. For example, if you take Ramaha, so in that also, what are the sounds? There is Ram is there. If you want to totally split it, so one example we'll see. What are the different sounds in Rama word? Ra, that is again a Ra Vyanjanam, Ra Vyanjanam is called a Refa in Sanskritam. So I'll keep saying Refa whenever there is a Vyanjanam like Ra. Ra, then that is Refa, Akara, then there is Makara, that is Ma Vyanjanam, Ma sound. Then after that there is a A, and then there is a Visarga. This is how the Ramaha is composed of. Ra plus A plus Makara plus Akara plus Visarga becomes Ramaha. So what we, at end of each word we have seen so far, there is a sound, that is called Akara, and then there is a Visarga sound.
This in is case a common of Surya, in case of Surya, it is Sa Rapara, Sa
In case of Surya,
Sa, that Vyanjana sa plus u
Correct. Dirgavu.
Dirgavu. And that is whatever you have said, ra vyanjana plus ya vyanjana plus a plus visarga.
Yes. Visarga sound. So suryaha is formed like this. Sakara, dirghaukara, refa, yakara, akara, visarga. Suryaha. So all the words we have seen so far, they end like a and then visarga. So let's see deepaha. Here also deepaha we have dakara, dvyanjanam, then dirgha ikara, pakara, akara, and visarga. Deepaha. Also at the end, a, kara, and aha, visarga is there. So all the words we have seen so far in our example, they are going to end like this. They are going to end in akara, and after that there is a visarga. So what we are going to say here is, excluding the visarga, okay? Exclude the visarga, forget the visarga, and what is before is the Moola Padam or Prakriti or the base word that we talked about. So the base word for Suryaha is what? Base Surya. Word for Suryaha is without Visarga, just Surya. Base word for Surya is, sorry, base word for Suryaha is just Surya. This is the base word or Moola Padam or Prakriti. This is a very important concept in Sanskritam. These are the base word or Prakriti or Moola Padam. So this we have to understand. So all the words we have seen so far in our example, they are of similar nature. So what is happening there is they are all ending in a sound. The base word is all ending in a sound. For example, if you take Ramaha, what is the base word or Moola Padam?
Ra.
Rama.
Rama. Moola Padam is Rama. So we have to keep aside Visarga. Then just take the word which ends in a sound. A sound. Okay. So that is called base or the Moola Padam or Prakriti of that word, Ramaha. Okay. So now, what are the other words here? Things? Deepaha. The base word is Deepa. Base word is Deepa. Then we have Syutaha. Here the base word is Moola Padam.
Syuta.
Syuta. Okay. Then what we have next is Karadipaha. Here also Deepa is same word. So Deepa is the Moola Padam. Balakaha. Balaka is the Moola Padam. Vaidyaha.
Vaidya.
So you got the idea. So here we have everything is marjara, everything is like that. So
marjara.
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 Marjara. All the words are like this. At the end we have Vidyalaya and then Shauchalaya. And in between there is Prakoshta.
Prakoshta.
Moola Padam is the word ending in a. So what this group, what we have studied so far, is the group of pullinga words which are ending in a sound, whose Moola Padam is ending in a sound. So that is the group we have studied. I mean, this is very small. There are a lot of other words which end in a, but this subset or this small group we have studied in our example is the group of pullinga words ending in a sound. So how do we say it in Sanskritam? Akaranta pullinga shabdaha. So I'll write it here. Akaranta. Akarantaha pullinga shabdaha. So we have studied in our example so far akaranta pullinga shabdaha, means shabda means word, pullinga is of course masculine, akara means the sound. Okay, so we have studied the words, masculine words which are ending in the sound a. The word itself, the actual word which refers to the object itself, is not ending in a because it is ending in a visarga. But when we say like this, what we mean is the moola padam of that word is ending in a sound. So akaranta pullinga shabdaha, all these are akaranta pullinga shabda. So we studied so far as example here all the words which are of the nature akaranta pullinga shabdaha. Akaranta pullinga shabdaha. Any question? So here makara moola shabda or moola padam is makara only without visarga. Kurma, vyagra, simha, ratha, hasta, these are all moola padam. So what we are going to do here is we are going to play a memory game. So I'll unmute somebody. Ravi Mahodaya, you can unmute yourself and let's quickly go through these words. So first you can ask the question, same thing, yeshaha, saha, kaha, and you can answer the what this thing is. Okay, you can start. So who wants to go? Sundaresh?
I'll take it. Eshaha kaha, eshaha samudraha.
So that is correct. So come on, next. Yeah. You can continue.
Eshaha balakaha.
First question.
Eshaha kaha.
Eshaha kaha. Eshaha balakaha.
Eshaha balakaha. Balaka. It looks like balaka, but it's policeman.
Arakshaha.
Arakshakaha.
Arakshakaha.
So I don't need to write. Arakshaka, you can see that on the screen. Next one.
Eshaha darpana.
Prathama prashnaha kaha. Prashnaha.
Eshaha kaha. Eshaha darpanaha.
Uttamam. Agre. Next.
Eshaha
vyagraha.
Eshaha kaha. Eshaha vyagraha.
Eshaha kaha. Eshaha vyagraha.
Next.
Pushpaha kaha. Yeshaha prakoshtaha. Yeshaha kaha. Yeshaha prakoshtaha.
Yeshaha prakoshtaha. Bahuttamam.
Saha kaha.
सह शमसः
So, just to avoid the confusion, so I request, let's make three slides per person, okay? Three slides per person. So, I am going to put everybody on mute again. So, let's start with Suresh Mahodaya. Suresh Mahodaya. Suresh.
Namaskar. सह कः
करेक्ट समीचीनं सः कः
आई फॉरगॉट
दैट्स फाइन दैट्स ओके सः चमसः
सः कः सः देवालयः
हां उत्तमं नेक्स्ट वन
सः कः सः मण्डपः
धन्यवादः सो मण्डप इज समथिंग दिस लुक्स लाइक अ स्टेज एनक्लोजर और अ गजीबो अस्तु नेक्स्ट वन यू कैन म्यूट योरसेल्फ महोदय सुरेश महोदय यू कैन म्यूट योरसेल्फ म्यूट योर लाइन एंड नेक्स्ट मालती भगिनी Malati Bhagini, if you are there, please unmute. Not there, also. Usha Bhagini.
Sir, you are asking me, sir?
I don't know, I see somebody called here Malati BM.
Yes, sir, actually that is the email ID, but this is Bindu Madhavan, sir.
Oh, sorry, sir, okay. Namaste, Mahodaya.
So should I try?
Yes.
Namaste. Saha kaha. Saha deepaha.
Deepaha.
Is it right?
Yes, yes. So because it is electric, you can say vidyut deepaha.
Vidyut deepaha. Okay.
Deepaha is also fine. Deepaha.
Okay,
lamp.
Sir.
Next.
Yes, yes, sir.
Next one, you can try. Next one, this one.
Saha. Saha kaha. Oh no.
Yes, yes. Esha.
This should be.
Esha. Esha
saha kaha. Esha kaha. Esha deepaha.
So are you, can you read Devanagari?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir, I am familiar with Devanagari.
Okay, okay.
Script.
Okay, this one, next one, can you try?
This one, sir. Eshaha kaha, eshaha deepaha.
No, no, this one, next one, okay, on my screen.
Next one, I am not seeing, sir. Correct.
Person with a stethoscope.
Can others see? I can't. I'm not.
We can see.
You can't see? What are you seeing on your screen?
We can see actually.
Person with a stethoscope. So, Eshaha kaha, Eshaha vaidyaha.
Eshaha vaidyaha. Good. Next, Suresh Mahodaya. Suresh Ahmad, you can try the next one.
Eshaha kaha, Eshaha Ramaha.
Okay.
Saha kaha, Saha Parvataha.
Uttamam. Agrika, Usha Bhagini, next one.
Hello.
Namaste,
sir. Saha kaha, saha glasin. Okay. Chashak. चषकः
सः चषकः
सः चषकः चषकः
सो व्हाट इज द मूलपदम हियर
चषक
चषक नॉट चषक चषक
ओके चषक
व्हाट इज दिस वन
एषः कः एषः आई डोंट गजः एषः गजः
या सो टू द वे टू गेट द क्विकर वे टू गेट फैमिलियर विद दिस वर्ड्स इज स्टार्ट यूजिंग देम इन योर एट योर होम नो wherever you live so when you are say when you see glass in your to drink water chashaka
chashaka
chashaka the entire sentence doesn't need to be in Sanskrit every day because still we don't know you don't know the all the words but
yeah.
you can replace the words you know with the Sanskrit words you can still talk in Sanskrit or whatever language you are talking but use these words in between
Okay.
They give me the water or jalam if you know jalam you know you can say jalam give me the jalam in chashaka like that you can start replacing these words
okay
you can try the next one
saha kaha saha vidyalayah
no uttamam dhanyavadah next one
thank you
madhuram bhagini
एष कः एष हस्तः अष्टः
नेक्स्ट् वन्
एष मङ्कीस् एष ऐ डोण्ट् नो फोर् मङ्की सर् वानरः एष वानर एष कः एष वानरः
So when you say Eshah
Eshah
so make sure to pronounce visarga
Eshah okay sir
Eshah
Vanarah
okay sir
next one Eshah dantah Eshakah एष दन्तः एषः दन्तः सः कः सः दन्तः
अस्तु धन्यवादः
थैंक यू सर
सः कः सः मार्यानः
एकनिमिष मोनिका हुई मोनिका या या यू वांट टू ट्राई
सः कः सः मार्जारः
भवतः नाम किम्
बिन्दुमाधवन्
बट् हू इस् मोनिका ऐ सी इन् ईमेल् ऐ डि और् नेम्
सोरि
दट्स् फैन् सो केन् या मोनिका केन् यु ट्रै वाट् इस् भवतः नाम किम् मोनिका you want to try I mean, we can't hear you okay there's some problem I think this one no, we can't hear you are you there monica bagini are you there No. Okay, that's fine. So let's go. Okay, Bindu Madhava. You can try this.
Saha kaha, saha marjaraha.
सः मार्जारः उत्तमम् नेक्स्ट् वन्
सः कः सः नो नाट् सः दिस् इस् एषः कः एषः ऐ डोण्ट् नो वाट् टु से फार् द ट्री सर् वृक्षः यस् सर् एषः वृक्षः एषः कः एषः सेना सैनिक
सैनिकः सो रिमेम्बर् देर् कुड् बि मल्टिपल् डिफ्रेण्ट् वर्ड्स् विच् यू मैट् नो आलरेडि बिकास् इफ् यु नो सम् इण्डियन् लाङ्ग्वेज् देर् कुड् बि अदर् वर्ड्स् आल्सो विच् मैट् बि आल्सो वेलिड् इन् संस्कृतं बट् रैट् नौ वी आर् स्टडिङ्ग् दीस् पर्टिक्युलर् वर्ड्स् विच् आर् अकारान्त पुल्लिङ्ग् मीन्स् द वर्ड्स् मस्कुलिन् वर्ड्स् विच् आर् एण्डिङ्ग् इन् अ सौण्ड् सैनिकः ओके नेक्स्ट् वन्
सः कः सः रथः
अगेन्
सः कः सः रथः
जस्ट् दट् इस् ओके दट् सौण्ड्स् गुड्
रथ
जस्ट् मेक् श्योर् दट् थ इस् प्रोनौन्स्ड् प्रापर्लि थ नाट् थ रथः रथः
रथः
the next dhanyawada next one let's go back to anupama bhagini
hi namaste mohoday
namaste
should I try
no anupama bhagini all others
kaha eshah suyah
tamam next
eshah kaha एषः कुक्कुरः
कुक्कुरः
एषः कः एषः दीपः करदीपः
करदीपः
हस्तदीपः
सः कः सः दन्तकूजः
उत्तमं धन्यवादः भगिनि नमस्कार नेक्स्ट् वन् लक्ष्मीकान्त महोदय एनी क्वश्चन् हियर्
नै फार् करदीपः केन् वी काल् एस् हस्तदीपः
ऐ मीन् देट् इस् ओके जनरलि ओके बट् just to make it convenient for everybody not only in this class but generally in the usage to understand some words are commonly used like that karadipa so though you can technically there is nothing wrong in saying hastadipa but because everybody is familiar with these words for certain objects well it is convenient to use them so everybody understands those words
dhanyawad
Also, as I understand, Kara is the hand, whereas Hasta is specifically the palm. Is that a correct understanding?
So, yeah, I mean, I will, not exactly. So, when we study the different parts of Shariram, or body, we'll see what is those, what are those things. नेक्स्ट् कर्ता महोदय कर्ता
यत् एषः कः एषः खडः
घटः
खडः
न न घटः
खडः
दट् सी दट् टकार ट सौण्ड् इस् नाट् ड घटः
सह कः सह शौचालयः
शौचालयः करेक्ट नेक्स्ट वन
सह कः सह स्यूतः
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 उत्तमं धन्यवादः नेक्स्ट वन लक्ष्मीकांत
धन्यवादः
सः कः सः कूर्मः
कूर्मः
सः कः सः बालकः एषा कः एषा पादः
एषः पादः
एषा कः एषः सिंहः एषः कः एषः
सिंहः एषः सिंहः
धन्यवादः
सिंह
नहीं वी कॉल इट सिंह इट इज सिंह ओके
इट्स ओके सिंह हां सिंह लाइक सम पीपल कॉल इट सिंह अस्तु धन्यवाद अग्रे गौरी भगिनी नेक्स्ट बैक टू यू
सह 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 शिक्षकः एषः कः एषः मकरः
बहु उत्तमं जानाति भगिनी सर्वं शी नोस् आल् दीस् वर्ड्स् अस्तु ऐ थिङ्क् वी हेव् रीच्ड् द एण्ड् आफ् दिस् उदाहरणं सो दिस् पुल्लिङ्ग अकारान्त पुल्लिङ्ग एक्साम्पल्स् आर् डन् So these are, we have tried to, this one, did it, this is Kandukaha, Kandukaha ball. So there is, these are some of the commonly used words every day. I mean, we don't use tiger and lion, but you should know that. So the next one is... Agresaramah means we will move on. Agresaramah. So this is a common sentence we are going to use. Agre means next. Saramah. Move. We move. So far, itapurvam vayam akaranta pullinga padani drishtavantaha. Itapurvam means before this. Vayam means we. అకారాంత పుల్లింగ పదాన్ని దృష్టవంత మీన్స్ విలుక్డ్ యాట్ అకారాంత పుల్లింగ పదం మీన్ మస్ట్ ద వర్డ్స్ ఎండింగ్ ఇన్ అ సౌండ్ అండ్ దోస్ ఆర్ మస్కులిన్ వర్డ్స్ సో నౌ ఇదానీ వయం అకారాంత నపుంసకలింగ పదాన్ని పశ్యామః అకారాంత నపుంసకలింగ పదాన్ని పశ్యామః సో విల్ ఇదానీ మీన్స్ నౌ విల్ సీ ద వర్డ్స్ ఎండింగ్ ఇన్ అకార అ సౌండ్ అండ్ విచ్ ఆర్ ఇన్ న్యూటర్ జెండర్ నపుంసకలింగ సో సిమిలర్ టు దాట్ ద సేమ్ క్వశ్చన్ ఆన్సర్ ప్యాటర్న్ ఫార్ అండ్ నియర్ సో వాట్ వాజ్ దట్ బిఫోర్ For the pullinga, it was saha, eshaha, kaha. And similarly, in the napunsakalingam, for neuter gender words, we are going to use tat, etat, and kim. If it is far, then it will be tat. If it is close by, it will be etat. And the words for word for question is kim. So the these are the neuter equivalent or napumsaka linga samanartha or samana padani, means similar words, like for pullinga it was, if it is far it was saha, for
sir, but we used bhavata hakim.
We'll talk about it. So then for this it was kaha. These are for the pullinga, and for napunskalinga we are going to use this. It's not the that far, this near, and who, neuter question mark. Okay, the question is bhavatyaha kim. Is that the question?
Yes. So I mean that is pullinga, no?
Bhavataha nama kim? Question is very good. There, when we say bhavataha nama kim, so here we are saying bhavataha, use it for pullinga, bhavatyaha use it for strilinga, but why are we saying kim? That is the question, as I understand. This kim is napumsakalinga, that is correct. And napumsakalinga word here is nama. In this sentence, napumsakalinga word is nama. That is why we are using kim in this.
Okay, understood.
In a way, we can also, supposing we don't use the word bhavataha, so if I'm right in front of a person, so I can always say nama kim.
Say that again, once again.
So generally we learn that we say bhavataha nama kim. Supposing I'm standing right in front of you, I can just say that nama kim.
Yes.
So in that sense it becomes a neuter gender question. Is that correct?
Yeah, otherwise also the kim is being used in that sentence because nama is always neuter. Whether you use just nama kim, the kim comes, is attached to that nama. So nama is a napumsakalinga padam, napumsakalinga shabda. So that is why kim is napumsakalinga.
Simply we can say tava nama kim.
Yes, tava is, tava you can use, but again nama and kim, they go together.
Yes, okay.
Whether you use tava, bhavataha, bhavatyaha, whatever, but kim is attached to nama. Kim is napumsakalinga because nama is napumsakalinga. So with this we'll see some of the examples in the neuter gender, napumsakalinga. So this would be more interesting because here there won't be animals mostly, okay? Mostly the other non-animals here. Okay, so tat kim, tat pustakam. So this is the first one. Tat, because we are pointing away, far away. Far means it doesn't need to be in a different city. Even little bit away from you, you want to refer to it. So what is that? So to ask that, tat kim, tat pustakam. So answer will be tat pustakam. Same thing, tat, question, prashnaha. Prashnaha will be tat kim, tat jalam.
So ending m is no gender, something like that.
Yeah. So for in the case of pullinga padam, for example, Ramaha, it ended in visarga. But not all the pullinga padas are ending in visarga. So that is why I introduced you to the base word, moola padam or prakriti, wherein those set of examples we studied for the pullinga shabda, they all end, the moola padam ends in a sound. That's why we call them akaranta pullinga shabda. But here, what we are going to study examples, just as example, all these are akaranta napunsakalinga shabda. These are also ending in a only, mula padam, not the word for the object itself, but the mula padam. Or pustakam is just pustaka. Without that makar at the end, just pustaka. So this is also ending in a at the end, just the mula padam. After that we are adding a ma sound, the ma vyanjanam or makara, if we want to use it in a sentence or to refer to an object. But basic word.
So excuse me, sir. Mm-hmm. Now I understood why you made me to tell Madhura, because I am in feminine. Madhura means it is, because it's ending in M, it becomes an object. Is it so, sir? Not like that.
So we are right now in the beginning. Hold on, let me mute because there is echo coming. Madhuri is
also name.
So we are studying only few examples of certain categories. Now, so the first category, first group we took is the akaranta pullinga words, means the masculine words which are ending in, whose mula padam is ending in a, and their actual word is ending in visarga. Now here, this example, this is a very small group we are taking. In this example, in the group of this, in this group, we are taking the words whose mula padam is ending in akara, but gender is neuter. So first we took the same, the word mula padam ending in a sound, but the gender is pullinga. Now, in this next one, we are taking napunsakalinga padas ending in a sound. Now, there could be other words which are napunsakalingam, which may not end in a, and which may not be, we may not add ma at the end. There could be different endings. So that is not the actual criteria, but the main thing is that in Sanskritam, so there are different words, like there are pullinga words ending in a, there are pullinga words ending in a. Okay, there are pullinga words ending in E, there are pullinga words ending in dirgha E and U, and there are other pullinga words ending in vyanjanam also, like there are pullinga words ending in P, and there are a lot of words, mostly all of them, mostly all different swaras and vyanjanams, everything. And there are three, there are again napunsakalinga words ending in A, the Napunsakalinga words ending in A, and so on. But when it comes to Strilinga words, there are Strilinga words ending in A, there are Strilinga words ending in Rasva I, there are Strilinga words ending in Dirgha I, Rasva U, Dirgha U, and so on. And of course, there are Strilinga words ending in Vyanjanam also, like Na, and whatever, Ka, different, Pa, the many letters. But there are no strilinga words. This is an exception, or this is how the Sanskrit language is there. There are no strilinga words ending in a. There are no strilinga words ending in a. Means what I mean? Word means mula padam. Mula padam ending in a. And to the mula padam is not directly used in a sentence or in a usage. When we say Rama is a mula padam, Rama itself directly is not used in prayoga or usage, or is not used in a sentence. It cannot be used, okay? Or it should not be used. we must add a something either a visarga or something to it, depending on how we want to use it in the sentence. We have to add something. There are rules. We'll study that step by step. But for now, just understand that we have to use some suffix, okay, to the moola padam. The moola padam directly as it is, raw moola padam cannot be used. So we have to add something to it in order for that padam or the shabda to be used in a sentence. Now, there are no words in Sanskritam, moola padam.
Sir, is that true for names also?
Yeah, names also, yes. Any word, names, objects, anything.
Okay.
There are no moola padam, no strilinga moola padam ending in a. So in case of madhuram, what I am saying is, in case of madhuram, the moola padam becomes madhura, okay, because we are adding ma there. Okay. So the moola padam becomes madhura, which is invalid in Sanskrit. Okay. So there is no strilinga moola padam ending in a. So that's why I am thinking it should be different, like in moola padam ending in a, then that word can be used in a sentence as a name also. If it is a moola padam ending in a, then it becomes madhura. Then if you want to use it in a sentence, either it has to be a pullinga or it has to be an apunsakalinga. If it is a pullinga, we add a visarga to refer to an object. And if it is a napunsakalinga, we add ma. We add ma at the end if it is a napunsakalinga, because the moola padam is ending in a sound. So then we can, madhuram means, actually madhuram is a word. There is a word in Sanskrit. Madhuram means sweet, just sweet. Sweet object, something. But it is not a living thing. It's not an animal or not a person. It is a sweet thing, or sweet, some laddu or something. Or the taste itself, sugar. The madhuram taste.
Sugar, no?
Madhura, whatever snacks, any snack which is sweet can be called madhuram. And the taste itself is also called madhuram. So next what we have, vanam. So question prashna, what will be the prashna?
Tat kim?
Tat kim?
Tat vanam. Tat vanam.
Next one.
Etat kim? Etat pushpam.
This is the part. Cropping.
Oh.
Tat, sir. Anybody else?
Etat kim? Sorry, sir.
No, that's fine. You can finish this. Etat kim?
Etat kim? Etat patram.
Patram.
Anybody? Usharani?
Tat kim? That seva phalam.
Apple. If you just say phalam, that is also okay. Phalam is fruit.
Okay.
Seva phalam, if you want to be exact, like apple.
Tat kim? Tat aranga phalam. Naranga phalam. Naranga phalam. Naranga phalam.
Good, okay. Dhanyavada. Next, what, anybody else? Rama Prasad?
किम्
द्राक्षाफलम्
द्राक्षाफलम्
नेक्स्ट्
हेम हियर् सर् एतत् किम् एतत् आम्रफलम्
ओके नेक्स्ट्
कदलीफलम्
ओके दीस् आर् द वेरि कामन् वर्ड्स् वी केन् यूस् एव्री डे कदलीफलम् नेक्स्ट्
तत् किं तत् भोजनं
भोजनम् इन् जनरल् फुड्
एतत् किम् एतत् पयोहिमम्
अस्तु धन्यवादः नेक्स्ट् एनिबडी एल्स् वी हव् गाट् कपल् मोर् मिनिट्स् अनुपमा भगिनी वाण्ट् गो
एतत् किम् एतत्
एतत् किम् एतत् वातायनम्
वातायनम् वातायनम् हा विण्डो
विण्डो तत् किं तत् द्वारम्
सो देट्स् पीपल् आर् लैक् दे आर् पर्टिक्युलर् सो इफ् इट् इस् शार्ट् हैण्ड् शार्ट् हैण्ड्
एतत्
एतत्
एतत् नगरम्
अस्तु धन्यवादः रामप्रसाद् महोदय यु वांट् टु ट्राई रामप्रसाद्
तत् 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 किं तत् फनेकम् तत् फेनकम्
फेनकम्
तत्
फेनकम् फेनकम् मीन्स् सोप्
सोप्
नेक्स्ट्
एतत् किं किम् एतत्
नाणकम्
नाणकम् एतत् नाणकम् तत् किं तत् नेत्रम् तत् किं तत्
So, remember here, so in the Pullinga example, Akaranta Pullinga was also there, Padaha, right?
Correct.
So, there was a word called Padaha, that was a Pullinga, now we are using, say for the same object, we are using Charanam. So, the Lingam, object is same, but the Linga of the word could be different. So, Padaha, Charanam, both means the same thing.
Sir, can we say padam?
No, no. Padaha pullinga.
Oh, okay.
So all the pullinga words, so far we have seen, the moola padam ended in a sound, but when we want to use them for the, in the sentence or just the usage, we will have to add the visarga, padaha only.
Okay. So can we, what do we say for 2 feet?
We'll come there, we'll come, yeah, because 2 feet, 3 feet, we'll have to see. These are, this, we are talking only about 1 foot, one okay. foot is padaha.
Okay, so we will study that afterwards.
Yes, yes, we'll come. So
okay.
If we do that now, it will be confusing.
Yeah, I remember because I studied Sanskrit in high school. I remember from then little bit.
Yeah, yeah. In the schools, usually those are introduced in a different way.
Yeah.
Right. So we are right now, we are just learning the words for different objects, everyday usage, like everyday charana, padaha, hastaha.
Right. Yeah.
So just to become familiar with the words first. Then we'll see then we'll see how to if there are more yeah. and all this.
Sir, one small doubt, sir. When we tell Krishna Pada Charana means it denotes two. No, sir? When you tell Krishna Pada Charanam, it denotes two, no sir?
Krishna Pada Charana Pada Charanam? No, actually, no, actually.
Actually,
we have to look at the sentence.
Okay, sir.
I request all of you to, when you go back home and then during the week until we meet next week, please go through these slides, go to that question answer pattern and try to use them in your day-to-day sentence, day-to-day use. And also, you can also go to that spokensanskrit.org. You can try to find new words there and just increase your vocabulary. But at least start with these words and we'll see more words. These are, we saw some of the pullinga words, we saw some of the napumsakalinga words, which we have not completed it. We'll also see some of the strilinga words later, and then we'll start forming some basic sentences after that. Okay. Astu, dhanyavadah, namaskarah.
Next Saturday I will not join you.
Okay, no problem.
I will be on traveling, but I'll go to your video later.
Sure, thank you.
Namaskaram,
Namaskaram.